Hi, welcome to yet another episode of Politically Fit, the one and only show on mynation.com that talks about not just the health of the nation, but also your health. And today on the show, we have two very important topics. On the political front, on the political menu, we discuss whether the opposition has undermined India's position after the Pulwama attacks. And on the fitness front, we discuss how to do a good arms routine. So today we are going to talk about training our arms. Arms includes biceps, triceps and forearms, but today we are only going to focus on the bicep. The bicep is a small muscle, it's not a very big muscle. So typically, I only do about 4 exercises, 4 sets in each exercise and about 10 to 12 repetitions in every set. I don't want to overtrain my biceps. In fact, overtraining it will mean that your biceps won't be as big and won't grow as much as you want them to. So we're going to start with an exercise called the dumbbell curls. These are two dumbbells. We pick them up and we just go behind and start by taking them up one after the other. Feel the crunch at the top. Exhale when you reach the top. And this is a dumbbell curl. But while we're doing this and we do about 12 repetitions, 4 sets each, let me talk about how the opposition undermined India's stand after the Pulwama attacks. Well, the opposition claimed, and Rahul Gandhi was at the forefront, that they would stand with the country and they would stand with the armed forces and the government in its response to Pakistan after the Pulwama attacks. But a week after that, you saw a whole range of opposition leaders come out and score political points on the Pulwama issue. Right from Congress's top leaders, including Digvijaya Singh, who called it a Durghatna, to Randeep Surjewala, who called it a homegrown so-called terrorist attack, to Mamata Banerjee, and a whole range of leaders who condemned Narendra Modi, and in the haste of condemning Narendra Modi, alleged that this entire Pulwama attack was actually linked to politics. And Pakistan had a field day. Its media, its Pakistani national media, Pakistani radio, and all the outlets in Pakistan used the statements of the opposition leaders to highlight that Pulwama may perhaps have been a political project that took place in India rather than a terrorist attack that took place from their soil. So after the dumbbell curls, we move on to an exercise called the barbell curls. This is a barbell, and we take a grip which is about shoulder width apart, and then we do the curls. Back has to be straight. 4 sets of 10 to 12 repetitions each. While we're doing this, let me tell you about one more statement of another senior Congress leader, B.K. Hariprasad. Now, B.K. Hariprasad, who was General Secretary of the Congress Party, Rajya Sabha MP of the Congress Party, now said that it could have been a match fixing between Imran Khan and Modi, the entire Pulwama attack. Now, statements like these, statements like Randeep Surjewala's homegrown so-called terrorist statement, statements of Digvijay Singh calling it a Durghatna or an accident, actually go on to prove that this wasn't really a terror incident or a terror attack, but somehow India had a role to play in it. And these statements are extremely, extremely worrying because they undermine India's position at the international forum. Imagine this, India goes to the United Nations, India goes to other forums and says, Pakistan has sponsored these terrorist attacks, Pakistan has supported these terrorist attacks, and Pakistan then uses the statements of these opposition leaders to bolster its claim that it had nothing to do with Pulwama and that this was all an in-house job done by the Indian government to score some political brownie points before the elections. This is what happens when the country doesn't stand united on an issue like national security and terrorism. So after the barbell curl, we take the EZ bar. The EZ bar has an advantage that it allows you to have a wide grip or, as in this case, a closer grip. And a closer grip allows you to focus on the outer bicep. Again, you do 4 sets each of 10 to 12 repetitions. And while I'm doing this, let me tell you what the Congress Party said about B.K. Hariprasad's atrocious statement of match fixing between Imran Khan and Narendra Modi. Priyanka Chaturvedi, the official spokesperson, said that this was an individual statement. Now, how is it that statement after statement from the Congress party, whether it's Chela Kumar, whether it's Digvijaya Singh, whether it's B.K. Hari Prasad, whether it's Manishankar Iyer, are always categorized as individual statements. If they are indeed individual statements and they are against the party line, why doesn't Rahul Gandhi act on these leaders? Is there a silent endorsement that he gives to these leaders when they make statements that actually support and endorse the Pakistani stand on Pulwama? After the EZ bar curl, this is an exercise which I find very effective. It's called the preacher curl with a dumbbell. You do it alternatively, one hand first and the other hand the next. Again, you do four sets, 10 to 12 reps each. And the idea is not to do very heavy weight, but to go all the way up and hold the crunch at the top and then go back down again and again take the weight up before going fully down. And this helps in attaining what is called a good bicep peak. So you do 10 to 12 repetitions on one arm and then you switch the arm and you take the dumbbell in the other arm and do another 10 to 12 repetitions. Now, while these opposition leaders are busy being Pak apologists, it must be understood that Pakistani opposition has spoken in one voice, and a reference to this was made by Shah Mahmood Qureshi and other leaders, that while the Pakistani opposition stands united with their government, the Indian opposition has actually been divided on the issue of Pulwama and the airstrikes after that. In fact, a lot of the opposition leaders not only suspected the timing of Pulwama, but also questioned the efficacy of the airstrikes conducted by the Indian Air Force in the aftermath of Pulwama on the morning of 26th February. You've seen the tweets of Navjot Singh Sidhu, who basically said that only a few trees may have been uprooted. You had other leaders like Digvijaya Singh asking for proof, as was provided in the case of Osama bin Laden. Well, to be fair, no proof was actually provided by Barack Obama after the Operation Geronimo was conducted to take out Osama bin Laden. In fact, Obama came out and did the press conference, and none of the leaders of the opposition, the Republican Party and the opposition in America, actually questioned him or doubted him. And here, when Surgical Strike 1 took place, it was the DGMO, an official of the Indian Army, who conducted the press conference, saying that they had struck terror launch pads across the line of control. Even in the case of Surgical Strike 2, the airstrikes, it was the Air Chief Marshal, Mr. Dhanoa, who came out and said that they had hit the targets. Now, the figures could have been different, or the figures were not really that important, and political leaders can be guilty of over-exaggerating the figures at times. But should that have been a reason to question the Indian Air Force and the armed forces and whether they were able to uproot only trees or were able to actually deliver on the targets that they had been assigned? That is a question that the opposition must answer. So the last exercise we are going to do is called the hammer curl. It's done with dumbbells again, and it replicates the movement of using a hammer, and therefore it's called a hammer curl. We can do this alternatively, one arm at a time, or you can do both arms together, four sets of 10 to 12 repetitions each. And this works well on the length of the bicep as opposed to the bicep peak, which was done on the preacher bicep curl, which we did just a moment ago. Now, while we're doing 10 to 12 repetitions of this exercise, let me tell you that there have been some leaders who are guilty of giving figures like 250 terrorists dead, 300 terrorists dead in the airstrike, something that the Air Force did not do, and something that hasn't been really confirmed by any authoritative agency. Now, one can find them guilty of overvalorizing the achievements of our armed forces or the Air Force, but that is still better than questioning whether the Air Force was able to achieve anything at all, whether the Air Force was able to strike those targets in Pakistan-occupied Kashmir at all. And that, in fact, has a detrimental impact on the psyche of the Indian Armed Forces and the Air Force when you ask for proof of a surgical strike, when you ask for proof of the airstrike. And therefore, those leaders from the opposition who, just to score political brownie points in their opposition to Narendra Modi, keep targeting the Indian Armed Forces and Air Force, should be careful, because their stand actually undermines India's position in the international forums when it comes to tackling Pakistan on the issue of terror. And when it comes to national security, all parties must be united. So this is it from me, Shehzad Poonawalla, for Politically Fit for today. After your exercise, always, always remember to do a few good stretches that cool down your body and allow you to relax. And a message for the opposition too. Question the government. It is indeed your right and your duty to question them at every stage, but at the right platform and at the right time, and not in a manner that seems like you are questioning the armed forces or the country itself. Signing off from Politically Fit. See you next week.